Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 16.1 Beta 4 is out to developers, and iOS 16.1 Public Beta 4 should be out fairly soon. Now this came in at 672.4 megabytes, that's on the iPhone 14 Pro Max, and it was about 5 to 700 megabytes on all the devices you have here. Now, along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 16 Beta 11, or iPadOS 16.1 Beta 5, whatever you want to call it, also macOS 13 Beta 10, tvOS 16.1 Beta 4, and HomePod OS 16.1 Beta 4. There is no watchOS 9.1 Beta 4 yet. For some reason, Apple didn't release that. Now, let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. Now, if we tap on the version number, you can see the build number is 20B5064C. We're one step closer to an A. A is typically the last beta before we have a release candidate and final release to the public. We'll talk more about that a little bit later, but let's talk about what's new. The first thing is there is a new modem update in this on the 14 devices, so we went from version 1.13.00 to 1.13.01. The number may vary depending on the device you have, though. The first thing is there's a visual change to the dynamic island in specific situations. So if we have a dark wallpaper, so if we go over to the astronomy wallpaper with the moon here, you'll see it's completely black at the top. You can't see the dynamic island. If maybe you go into music, hit play, swipe home, you'll see the dynamic island at the top is now outlined with sort of a mark to let you know where it is. Otherwise, it's not there. So if I switch over to a different wallpaper, switch back to what we had before, you'll see that even though it's still playing, the line goes away. Again, switch back to a dark wallpaper. Anytime you're interacting with the actual dynamic island, it will show an outline now if the wallpaper is dark, just so you can see what's going on. Now, the first time you open up Messages, Apple has actually introduced a fairly thorough splash screen. So if we go into Messages, you can see here it says Shared with You. Content shared in Messages can automatically appear in apps such as Music, Photos, Safari, and more. As we swipe over, it says Shared with You in Photos. See relevant shared photos and videos from Messages in the Photos app. And the third one says pins. Pins let you mark shared content you want to come back to. Now, some of this was in iOS 15, but they've made this more thorough with iOS 16 and are making people aware of the different features there. So that's something that's been changed. Now, if we go back home and we take a look at some of the new features that came with AirPods Pro 2, there was a bug with AirPods Pro 2 where it would actually show you that you needed to replace the battery already. However, with AirPods Pro 2nd generation, we get a new feature that allows you to have adaptive transparency. Now, we were seeing this with AirPods Pro 1st generation. So let me see if this will connect. Seems like it might be a bug here. Let's get it to connect here. There's the menu. And if we scroll down, you'll see adaptive transparency. They've removed this. It actually showed up with AirPods Pro 1st generation that I have here. You can tell by the case here. If I open this up, wait for it to open, give it a moment to connect again. You can see my AirPods Pro, the adaptive transparency is gone. This was showing up for AirPods Pro 1st generation and AirPods Max. They've removed this. So maybe it has to do with the H2 chip and it was just a mistake, but they've removed it for those devices. So it's a change that I don't think many people want to see, but they have changed it. And also Mark Gurman reported on that saying it was a bug yesterday. So it looks like it's a bug and they've removed it and it's not coming back, unfortunately. Now, as far as other new features and changes, there's some small changes from here on out. So as we get closer to the final release, you'll see some small changes. If we go to accessibility, then we go to touch and then assistive touch. If we go into customize assistive touch or the top level menu, you'll see here that they've changed some of the icons. And thanks again to Steve Mosier for helping me out with some of this, but you'll see these icons for the app switcher or device. They've been updated, but they don't fit properly. They've been updated to include the dynamic island, as you can see there. So that's something that's been updated here for different icons as far as different things you can change, but for some reason it doesn't look right. So if we go back to App Switcher, it changes to the dynamic island for this device, but it doesn't fit in the overall design. So hopefully they fix that in the future. Also, they've made some changes throughout. So if we go into Health, under Health, go to Browse, go down to Vitals, under Vitals, go to Menstruation. You'll see here we have some information about it. They've made some changes compared to the previous version. So if we go to the same place on the previous beta, again, go down to the same menu, you'll see it's been changed. So it says about menstruation, learning about other things, factors, and more. And as you can see, they've just changed some of the graphics or given more information about it. That seems to be different on iOS 16.0.2 as well. So they keep changing this throughout. Also, if we go to delete the wallet app, which we can do in 16.1, hit remove, hit delete, you'll get another warning that says, to delete this app, first remove any cards and settings. Previously, with beta 3, it said to delete this app, first turn off Apple Cash and remove any cards and settings. So they've made some slight changes there. There's also some slight changes in wording in the camera settings. So Apple is correcting little mistakes here and there that they have within the overall settings and wordings. And if we go down to camera, you'll see under camera, we'll scroll down under camera here. And then if we go under formats, under Pro RAW resolution, we have 48 megapixels. Before, it said Pro RAW photos on the wide lens at 1x can be saved at 12 or 48 megapixels. Well, that camera is not 48 megapixels, so they've actually corrected it on the new version where it says Pro RAW photos on the main camera at 1x can be saved at 12 or 48 megapixels. So they've corrected some of the wording since the only camera that's 48 megapixels is the new main camera. The others are 12 megapixels. Also, Apple is getting ready for satellite connectivity on the newer phones, the iPhone 14, 14 Pro, 14 Pro Max, and upcoming 14 Plus that launches this Friday. There's going to be, it appears to be demos, you can try this out. However, I'm not seeing anything here physically yet. However, throughout the code, this is there, so they're getting ready for the overall launch of satellite connectivity, and we'll be able to see what it looks like. So when 16.1 comes out, it looks like it will launch with that if Apple actually enables it. However, so far, it's just not there. Now, officially today, Matter launches. Matter is a new standard that allows you to connect different devices to your home, and we should see more and more of those devices. Apple added Matter support with iOS 16 and continues to refine it in 16.1. So it really isn't there until 16.1, and then they've fixed a bunch of issues. We'll take a look at that in a moment as far as the release notes, but I wanted to share that with you. Now they have fixed a few things, which is really nice. So if we go into music and then maybe play a song, let me turn it all the way down. We'll play a song. It goes to the dynamic island, of course. And then if we go to the home screen or lock screen, you'll see here they've fixed the music animation. When you tap on it, it smoothly transitions down into the music player. So before it didn't work, it would just sort of bounce into it. It didn't look right. Now it's been fixed and it looks much, much better. So I'm glad they've actually fixed that. Also, AirDrop seems to be working much better. It's super fast now, and if we go into photos, maybe we'll AirDrop this little screenshot of the update. So if we go into AirDrop here, maybe we'll just AirDrop it to iPhone 11, and it sends right away. Now it's on the iPhone 11. So it seems much faster. Some of the animations may have changed slightly, but I wasn't able to detect that easily anyway. But some changes have been made there. It seems to be much faster. Also, previously, the ESPN rotation bug has been fixed when you're playing video in here. So if we go in, if you watch anything that's live and then you rotate to landscape, now it fills the screen properly. That's still working with beta 4. So that's a great thing. One thing there is still a problem with, it seems, is the startup sound. So what happens is you can turn this on in settings under accessibility. I've shown this before where you have the overall sounds that are here. So if we go to audio visual, you'll see power on and off sounds. These don't work properly for me. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. So if I power off here, shut it off, there's no sound. I do feel haptic feedback and it vibrates, but there's no sound at all. On public versions, it seems to work just fine. So we'll give it a moment and power it back on. Sometimes it works when powering on, sometimes it doesn't. So again, we'll give it a moment. Let me try again here. Hold it down, see if it powers back on. And there, it worked that time. It hasn't worked the past couple times I tried this. So it's still fairly buggy and it does seem to be an issue, but it's only on the 14 Pro and Pro Max devices. Now, as far as 14 Pro and Pro Max specific bugs, Apple hasn't mentioned anything, and I'll show you that in a moment. But if we bring the brightness down, many people were seeing that in darker spots or darker areas on the display, it would flash. Other people couldn't hear someone when they were plugged in using CarPlay and talking on the phone, or people couldn't hear them. There's been loads of little issues here and there with the iPhone 14 launch this year. Apple hasn't mentioned that they've fixed any of those. So if we go into the feedback app, within the feedback app, if we go into the release notes, give it a moment to load here, you'll see that we have resolved issues for, it says uncertified accessory notifications might appear when pairing Matter accessories. Like I said, Matter launched today, and most of these have to do with Matter accessories. That's the only resolved issue under Home, and there's no other resolved issues in Beta 4 that they mention. So nothing iPhone 14 specific, although I would expect those with either this launch or a different update. So you'll see you might receive an alert to turn on Wi-Fi when pairing a Matter accessory. That's a known issue or a bug. They give you a workaround. Again, adjusting the color or color temperature might result in an unexpected color set on a Matter accessory. So a couple different issues, a few different issues with Matter accessories, and then that memory allocation issue is still there as well. So far, no fixes specific to iPhone 14. Now on iPadOS 16 Beta 11, all of the same changes are noted with the same bug fixes and more. However, in the code, there is a mention of using a fountain pen as far as one of the tip options for the Apple Pencil. I didn't find that within settings yet, but it looks like it could be coming soon or be used by additional apps. So I wasn't seeing it in notes or anything else, but other than that, I don't see anything else as far as iPadOS goes. Now, as far as overall performance, only using it an hour or two is not really enough to give you a sort of definite answer, but so far it seems smooth. ProMotion is nice and fast. And going into the App Store, I did see some lag when I went to update my app. So I went to refresh this and then scrolled through just to see what was new, make sure there were no Geekbench updates so I could have an accurate score as far as that goes later in the video. And it did lag a little bit, but maybe that's because it was loading from Wi-Fi. Otherwise, I haven't seen any lag throughout. So the overall phone and experience seems to be nice and fast, whether you're going into the App Store just loading. It opens up quickly, but again, it was loading a little strange. You'll see it's taking a while on the iPhone 11, but everything seemed to open like you would expect. Going into music is nice and fast. Scrolling and everything else is what you would expect. Now, as far as overall battery life has been hit or miss for me on Beta 3. I shared that this past weekend. If we go into my battery here on this device, of course, it's at 100%. It's a newer device. The last 8 days. Yesterday, I had 3 hours and 56 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 2 minutes of screen off time, and used about 40% of my battery. That's better than the days before. It seems to be getting better, but as Apple refines things with this, it should improve over time. The phone is a little bit warm this time around, just using it during this video, but nothing alarming. It's not super hot, and Apple regulates that itself using different sensors inside the phone, so not a whole lot to worry about there. As far as the next release, well, many people think we'll see iOS 16.0.3 as soon as tomorrow or maybe next week. The reason for that is Mac Rumors actually saw that in their analytics on their website when they were looking through. They saw that it was in use by someone looking at their website. So we could have that this week or next to address early problems, maybe those issues with the iPhone 14 series before the 14 Plus comes out on Friday, or some other issues as well, along with security updates. So we can expect that very soon. And also Apple stopped signing previous versions other than 16.0.2. So you can't downgrade to the original iOS 16 or 16.0.1. So we're stuck until we get a newer version. So hopefully we'll see that very soon. As far as iOS 16 releases, well, iOS 16 Beta 5 could be as soon as next week, or we could see a release candidate. Sometimes they skip an A release as far as the build number. We'll see a release candidate, and then maybe a final release the third week of October. However, that could be pushed out toward the end of October, as we are expecting the release of iPadOS 16 as well as macOS Ventura. So all of those things are expected, along with maybe an Apple event, but I don't think we're going to see that now. Probably just a press release for updated specs with iPads and maybe MacBook Pro updates. Maybe we'll get a little bit of a look at the Mac Pro, but I would hope we'd have some sort of event before the end of the year. Apple has pushed them to November before as well, so we could see something then. Now, as far as the benchmarks are concerned, I did run those quickly just to share with you. And you'll see here, if we go to the history, CPU, I ran this twice because the initial multi-core score was really low. It scored 1,891 for single core, 5,371 for multi-core. That's actually pretty good compared to previous weeks. So it's pretty good, a little bit low on multi-core, but this bumps up and down as you use it over time. Again, I'll be using it and I'll have a follow-up video on the weekend like normal. Now, if you've found anything else in iOS 16.1 Beta 4, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.